ورحمة الله وبركاته. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى آله وأصحابه وأزواجه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. اللهم اقسم لنا من خشيتك ما تحول به بيننا وبين معاصيك، ومن طاعتك ما تبلغنا به جنتك، ومن اليقين ما تهون به علينا مصائب الدنيا. اللهم متعنا بأسماعنا وأبصارنا وقواتنا ما أحييتنا واجعله الوارث منا. اللهم لا تجعل مصيبتنا في ديننا، ولا تجعل الدنيا أكبر همنا ولا مبلغ علمنا. اللهم واجعل ثأرنا على من اللهم ولا تسلط علينا من لا يرحمنا. اللهم يا رب العالمين واجعل ثأرنا على من ظلمنا، ولا تسلط علينا من لا يرحمنا. اللهم لا تسلط علينا من لا يرحمنا واجعل ثأرنا على من ظلمنا. وبعد، today is Monday and today's date is the 12th of المحرم for the year 1434 of the Hijra of the migration of our great beloved Prophet Muhammad رسول الله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم، which coincides with the 26th of November for the year 2012. Monday, as you know, is designated to study the seerah, the life of our great beloved Prophet Muhammad رسول الله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم. And literally we are in the last either few minutes or few hours of the life of Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. And today inshallah رب العالمين, under the title The Last Smile That رسول الله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم smiled in public, Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم last smile. And this hadith in Sahih al-Bukhari and others, and Sahih al-Bukhari, Imam al-Bukhari mentioned it in the book of al-Adhan, first time he mentioned it several times, but the first time in the book of al-Adhan, the book of calling the Adhan, أبواب صلاة الجماعة والإمامة, the chapters that relates to praying in congregation and the office of the Imam of the Salat. باب أهل العلم والفضل أحق بالإمامة. The people of knowledge, the scholars, and the people of virtue, of good conduct, have the right to be Imam. To be the Imam of the Salat. And I'm going, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen, to read the full text which compiled by Imam al-Albani rahmatullahi alayhi from all the narrations that Imam al-Bukhari rahmatullahi alayhi mentioned in all the places. And the hadith reads, an Anas ibn Malik radiyallahu anhu, Anas ibn Malik, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be pleased with him, an Anas ibn Malik al-Ansari radiyallahu anhu, وكان تبع النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وخدمه وصحبه. And he is the one who followed رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. And he was the servant of رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. And he was the companion of رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. And Anas ibn Malik, for those who do not know, he comes from a very, very influential family. And when رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم came to Al-Madinah, he was 10 years old. And his mother brought him, said, Ya Rasulullah, khadimuka Anas. This is Anas, your servant. I want him to serve you as long as you live. And she dedicated him to serve Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. So he was in the company of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam almost every waking hour of the life of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam for 13 years. And he says, Anas رضي الله عنه, the famous hadith, which boggles your mind. He said, what? خدمت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم 10 سنين. I served رسول الله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم 10 years. فما قال لي لشيء فعلته لما فعلته. ولا لشيء لم أفعله لما لم تفعله. And رسول الله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم. He said, I served رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم 10 years. And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم never told me for anything that I have done. Why did you do that? And Anas was a boy at that time. And never told me about something, about anything that I did not do. Why you did not do it? Our Sheikh, Sheikh عبد الرحمن عبد الخالق, حفظه الله وغفر له وعافاه, says what, when I heard this hadith, I had my family. So I said, well, that's a good lesson for me. Let me go and practice it in my house. He said, I could not last for 30 minutes. I could not last for what? 30 minutes. And from my experience, the house of Sheikh عبد الرحمن عبد الخالق and their family are very calm people, very delicate people, very soft, easy going. And look, when she brought him, look at the caring mother. When she brought him to Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, said, Ya Rasulullah, خادمك أنس, فادعو له. This is in Sahih al-Bukhari. She said what? She said, this is your servant Anas, pray to him. And Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم prayed to him what? اللهم أطل عمره, اللهم كثر ماله, اللهم كثر ولده. وفي رواية خارج الصحيح, sorry, اللهم كثر ماله, اللهم كثر ولده. وفي رواية خارج الصحيح, اللهم وأطل في إيش؟ في عمره. يا الله, increase him in life, or extend his life, extend his wealth, extend his children. And he said, well, and I think, واغفر له ذنبه, and forgive him his sins. And he said, when he became old, he said, look, now I am very old. And he lived to be over 100. Now, if I'm not wrong. And his children and of children's, they were over 100. And he became very rich. And he said, well, and I am waiting for what? The last one. Which is what? Which is the last one? May Allah forgive him what? His sins. And Anas ibn Malik radiallahu anhu was among the first 5 top narrators of what? The hadith of who? Of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So never ever underestimate anyone because of young what? Young age. Because of what? Young age. And although he was very young, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to confide in him his very, very personal, private matters. He trusted him with these things. And when he was very young, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him, go to somewhere and never ever tell anyone about what I told you. And his mother heard this. When he came back, he told him, what did Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tell you to do? Tell him what? ما كنت لأفشي سر رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم لأحد. I am not the one who is going to what? Tell the secret of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم to anyone. Even if you are, who is this one? His mother. So Anas رضي الله عنه said, أن أبا بكر كان يصلي بهم في وجع النبي صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم الذي توفي فيه حتى إذا كان يوم الاثنين وهم صفوف في الصلاة صلاة الفجر. He said, أبو بكر الصديق رضي الله عنه was the one who was leading the Muslims in صلاة ورسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم sick, his last sickness, which after that he died. And he kept leading them in salah until the day of Monday. The day of Monday. While they were in their lines behind Abu Bakr al-Siddiq رضي الله عنه in as-salah, in salat al-fajr, the dawn prayer. فكشف النبي صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم ستر الحجرة حجرة عائشة رضي الله عنها ففجأهم that while they were in صلاة الفجر praying behind أبو بكر الصديق رضي الله عنه رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم removed the curtain of the حجرة the room the compartment of who of عائجة and it was a surprise for them surprise because they thought what رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم healed cured and he is going to live longer ففجأهم ينظروا إلينا وهم في صفوف الصلاة so he surprised them by what while he was looking at them while they were what in their ranks in الصلاة وهو قائم كأن وجهه ورقة مصحف he was standing and his face was so beautiful as if it is what a page from what from المصحف from القرآن الكريم and this is the proverb مثل الجمال عند الصحابة if they want to describe something what beautiful they say what his face is as beautiful or as shiny as what as the page a page of what of القرآن الكريم ثم تبسم يضحك when he looked at them رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم his face was shining so beautiful then he started smiling and laughed and left. ففهممنا أن نفتتنا يعني في صلاتهم. When we heard him, when we heard his laughing, we almost messed up our what? Our صلاة. من الفرح برؤية النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. Because of our happiness in seeing what the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم فنقص أبو بكر رضي الله عنه على عقبيه ليصل الصف so when أبو بكر الصديق رضي الله عنه noticed that he backed up to pray in the what in the behind what behind him line وظن أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم خارج إلى الصلاة He did that because he thought that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is coming out to join them in what? In as-salah. فَأَشَارَ إِلَيْنَا النَّبِيُّ بِيَدِهِ أَنْ أَتِمُّوا صَلَاتَكُمْ And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam singled us to us with his hand, complete your salah. Complete your salah. ثُمَّ دَخَلَ الْحُجْرَةِ وَأَرْخَ السَّتْرَةِ فتوفي في آخر يومه ذلك فتوفي في آخر يومه ذلك then after that after he singled to us to complete the salah he what entered the compartment the حجرة and he what he put down the drapes he let the drapes fall down That means go back to covering and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam died at the end of that day. That day. Another narration and inshallah we'll close. I'm still reading in Sahih al-Bukhari. قال أنس رضي الله عنه لم يخرج النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ثلاثا. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم stayed in his house without leaving his house for three days. فأقيمت الصلاة and the salah the إقامة for the salah was made فذهب أبو بكر يتقدم. ها سو أبو بكر الصديق stepped ahead to lead the salah. فقال نبي الله صلى الله عليه وسلم بالحجاب فرفعه. So we notice that رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم moved the curtain and exposed himself. فلما وضح وجه النبي وما رأينا منظرا كان أعجب إلينا كان أعجب إلينا من وجه النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم حين وضح لنا. So when the face of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم became exposed, became clear, and we never saw any scene or any view more that we admire more than the face of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم when we saw him at that time. فأومأ النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم بيده إلى أبي بكر أن يتقدم. So Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم singled with his hand to Abu Bakr al-Siddiq رضي الله عنه to lead the salah. وأرخى النبي صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم الحجاب فلم يقدر عليه حتى مات. فلم يقدر عليه, يقول في الحاشية, فما قدرنا بعد ذلك على رؤيته ومشاهدة نوره صلى الله عليه وسلم. That means then Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم closed the curtain and from that moment no one was able to see him alive. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك. If you have any questions, corrections or other concerns, we'll entertain them in the remaining time. Otherwise, جزاكم الله خيرا for coming and جزاكم الله خيرا for listening. And we'll continue from where we pick, we'll pick up from where we left, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen, next week. Any question? Done? Okay. You can put it, last smile.